Welcome back to another video where you will be getting tips on career growth from people who have experience in that industry. Now, if you check on Google, an average of 1.5 million engineers are released into job market every year in India. You want to know what's a sad truth? Only 3-4% have the suitable skills to be employed in the engineering field, and only about 7-9% are able to handle core engineering tasks. So today, we have someone who is the Director of Engineering at Wood Abu Dhabi. She has over 26 years of experience in the engineering field. She graduated in mechanical engineering in 1989. So she's someone who has years of experience, and she will be telling us more on how to grow in the engineering field, how to prepare for interviews, what are the key skills you require in this field. Also, keep in mind that these videos are recorded over Zoom, so the quality will not be the best. But I can guarantee you, each of these videos will provide you ample amount of knowledge. So make sure you subscribe to the channel to watch more of similar content, and do like the video if you find it useful. So without further ado, let's welcome Ms. Bindu Satish. So ma'am, thank you for taking out your time to be a part of this video. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, Nikhil, you are welcome.
So ma'am, the very first thing which I want to understand is how to build a career in engineering, even if you're a fresher or you're someone with less years of experience.
Okay. As any other career, engineering also needs passion. Teenagers, while selecting engineering, they may not be able to take the branch to which their passions are related to. If they are getting the branch to which their passions also match, it is well and good. On the other hand, if they have not got it, what we should do? In the course of their studies, they shall look into one or two subjects where they are excelling in the college, and they should try to understand the industries related to these subjects. Once they graduate, steer your attention to get into those industries. And in that way, they can turn their passion into a successful career. Okay. And Nikhil, I would say that in engineering, options are unlimited. What you have to do is, you have to invest some initial time of your career for the selection and development of your future career. Study and learn as much as possible to build a strong foundation in the area you select. You have to be result oriented, and you may have to be open for changes also, because I am saying you that, okay, you can select a subject which you were very passionate with when you are selecting a career also, but sometimes the first job which you have selected may not be the one you want to continue or you want to pursue. So in that case, the changing the industries in the beginning of your career is possible. It will be very difficult for you to change your career after 5 years into working. Also, you may understand, any engineer, fresh engineer may understand that nobody, or maybe 1 or 2% may get their dream jobs. 98% of the people are not getting their dream job. We have to be ready to slog in the beginning of our career. You should understand that, okay, if you think that you will get an office job in the beginning of the career, probably you may not. You know, there was one joke during our college days. I'm talking about 90s, 80s, 80s and 90s. When we go into engineering, we used to feel that, oh, we became chief engineer, because at that time there were only 500 or 600 engineers who were going into engineering college from one state of India. So first year we become chief engineer. Second year we understand that, okay, we are only senior engineers. Third year we understand that we are only engineers. Fourth year, we understand that, okay, we have to become trainee engineers. And after the fourth year, we understand that we are not even a trainee engineer. Now we have to find out a job, then try to understand what exactly that job is asking us to do, because it may be totally different from what we have studied until then. It may be practical jobs, may be many much different from what you have studied in the books. So after the fourth year or after the engineering degree only, we will really start understanding what is an engineering job looks like. So what we studied is different from what we get. Even now I am in a career where engineering drawings is a must. You know, engineering drawing was the subject which I hated the most. So you can understand, you have to be ready to slog to learn something in the beginning of your career. And for me, I will tell you that I have really studied engineering drawings once more when I took this career in consultant. Consultants do everything through drawings. So I had to go to my first year books and study it once more. So these are the ways in which a junior engineer or a trainee engineer should start their career or will start their career.
Now, in terms of interview for an engineering role, what is the process for an interview, whether you are a fresh graduate or whether you are someone who comes with a couple of years of experience?
What normally we do is, the most of the companies shortlist the fresh candidates based on the reputation of their alma mater. The universities to which they have gone place a very big role in the selection. Grades they gained in the course is one another factor which we see when we are screening the CVs of freshers. And we go into the third year internships which they have done. And the fourth main thing which we go into the details is the final year project work or the final year thesis which the engineer graduate had done, and how they have thought while they were preparing the final year thesis, or whether they have cut and paste some documents from the internet and put it as a final year thesis. If you want to prepare properly for an interview, what you should do is, you should go through your first year, second year, third year main books, the fundamental books, because normally what happens is we forget what we have done studied in first year, second year and third year when we reach the fourth year. So you go through those fundamental books before going for such an interview. Example, if you are applying for a process engineer position, you should know Bernoulli's theorem. It is a must. Okay. And you should know the PVT laws, etc. You know, it is pressure, volume and temperature relations. Any engineer should know. And I have seen people who came for interview without knowing all these things. And if you are applying for a civil engineer position, you should know the bending moment and how the load is distributed. And these are the basics of civil. How one structure can be made, how much load it can take, and how you are calculating whether it is safe. So those things which you are studying in the third or fourth semester of engineering will be the fundamental for civil engineering which an interviewer will be looking at. Say for a mechanical engineering, what we normally see is, what is their knowledge on the mechanical basics, say strength of materials, then iron carbon diagram, which is 100% you know, we are studying from fourth semester, fifth semester, sixth semester, everywhere we are studying. All those basic things you should go through once more and get ready for the interview. And one more important thing is, you may be a very good orator, but you may not be able to present yourself in a technical meet, technical interview. Why? Because he was not able, he or she was not able to analytically explain the interviewer the answers to the questions they were asked. So be communicative in the proper way. you should make your interviewer understand what you really meant or what you really studied on that particular subject. And as I have done a lot of interviews in my life, I have never expected a mechanical engineer to know ASME or ASTM standards in the starting of their career. Say, if I am interviewing a person who had already 1 year or 2 year experience, then I may ask about ASME standard or ASTM standard sample. But knowing there is an American Society of Mechanical Engineers type of a body is there, even when you are doing your engineering, it will help you. That means a person who has general knowledge on ASME and ASTM will get more weightage when compared to a person who is totally blind on all this general knowledge. Now, coming to your second part of the question, for those who had already worked, what we will be looking at? Such type of interview sessions will be based on the experience they gained from the present job. So what you have to do is, you have to be prepared with the minute details of the job and the project which you have worked. You know, if he is going from the same field, from a field to the same field in a different competitor or different company, you can expect such type of questions. Say, I will tell you an example. If I'm a pipeline engineer, I go for an interview from one consultant to another consultant. Definitely, if I talk about a pipeline job, the other person who is interviewing me will be knowing about that particular job. Then he may ask you, from which point to which point that pipeline runs, and what is the size of the pipeline, and what is the terrain through which the pipeline is going, what was the material, and even they can ask what was the use of that particular project at that particular time. These type of details, into so much of details you have to go through before going for the interview, because you should expect the other person knows very well about the project which you are doing, because the industry is small, each industry is small, so everybody knows about all the projects. If an engineer we have is coming with 1 or 2 years experience from our competitor or from a place where or maybe from a different industry also, normally in the CV we will ask for the references. We will talk to the people whom they have given us references, and we may talk to the people whom they have not given us references but we know, because that will give us a real picture on how enthusiastic he is in the work. Because this world is very small, the industrial world is very small. Say, I will talk about oil and gas industry and the consultancy. We know each other. Almost all the seniors who are working in this field know each other. So if one person is coming from, say, A company to my company, I will be knowing somebody in the A company, and I will be asking them how this boy or girl was in his approach towards work. So try to have a very good professional relationship wherever you are working. It will help you. So these are the things which normally we see when we are taking a person.
So ma'am, you started as an assistant engineer at TCE, and with more than 26 years of experience, you're currently the engineering director at Wood. So in terms of leadership, in terms of leading and motivating a team, what has your key learnings been in this particular aspect?
Nikhil, it is a very, very good question. And I would say that you trust yourself. You trust your team. Lead the team with trust and empower the team. This is my leadership skills. And I would say that inclusive leadership is my key success factor. What is meant by inclusive leadership? I involve my team, take their opinion in any decision making processes. The decisions are taken as a team, so that we stand by each other at any given circumstance. Support and protect your team, whatever the situation may be. As normal human beings. We too are normal human beings. We engineers are also normal human beings who can make mistakes. Okay. Blaming or singling out one for a mistake is not a good approach for a leader. Take the mistake also to you, because you had taken the decision along with them to take that job or to do that job. So if a mistake happened, the mistake also happened from the team, not from any individual. Please remember this. It will help you as a good leader. Another thing which will help you as a good leader is always follow the protocol and the hierarchies. Never bypass the system. System bypassing is not good for our development of the career. More importantly, to be a good leader, you should listen not only to your team, the other team also, your clients also, and respect their opinion. And don't try to impose all your views. It doesn't mean that you have to say yes to everything what others say. What you can do is, you can listen to others, you can respect their opinion, and you can also put our opinion and our views, come to a common conclusion. This all will make you a good leader.
Ma'am, in terms of MBA or Masters, what are your thoughts on it? Do you think an MBA or Masters is required in today's date to grow in your career?
So shortlisting, definitely a higher qualification is preferable. However, that is not the criteria for final selection. The criteria I had already explained. The criteria is the fundamental knowledge which you have in engineering, that only in the first 4 years of engineering, not in your master's, because the master's may not be applicable for our industry. If it is applicable, that is different. In, like I explained in between, some of the industries need a master's, say like R&D. It is R&D for a particular role, particular business R&D. You require an M.Tech. However, during interview, we see whether person has done the higher studies with some vision or just did it for the sake of obtaining that degree. Therefore, higher studies are beneficial if it is done with some vision or you want to have a specialization in any technical field, or you want to develop your career in, say, finance or banking, etc. Doing it for the sake of degree does not help. And when you weigh it against the time and money you spent, if you are doing it just for a degree, it doesn't help you. My other suggestion is, if you are going for higher studies, select only reputed colleges. So in short, higher studies are good if it is done with a purpose. If it is only for an engineering job, then it is not required.
So ma'am, finally, if you had to give an advice to anyone who is probably in their engineering college or who is planning to start their career in engineering field, what would that be?
My first advice is, boys and girls, please do not expect to have the same cozy and easy life you had in your engineering time. Be ready to spend a lot of your personal time into building your career. Because this career is, engineering was 4 years, the career is another 40 years. So this 40 years of career you have to build in the first 1 or 2 years. Then it becomes a smooth sailing. But this 1 or 2 years, you have to be ready to spend a lot of your personal time. And one advice which I would give to you guys is, love the job you get and try to build on that. Because like Nigel was saying, number of job opportunities are less. So probably you may not get the job which you are looking for. So maybe you will be getting a job where you may have to slog little bit in the site. But take it. See the opportunities behind it. And I know personally so many engineers who started their career in the site and then came into design field. They are better than us who directly came into design field, because they have already seen the site. They know how exactly it looks like. In case it does not work out for you, for after, even after putting a lot of efforts, it is not working out for you, then I will not ask you to continue there. You look for alternatives. You get a job where you get a job satisfaction. Maybe this, again, I will tell you, all these things you should do in the first 2-3 years of your career. Don't jump from one type of career to another type of career in every 6 months. I have seen many people who failed drastically because of that. They switch their career every year, which is not a right decision. So make your career in the first 2 or 3 years. Make the area in which you want to prepare, you want to develop your career in the first 2-3 years itself. For that, you have to have good network. Some people who can give you advice, say, anybody you can refer to me, I will give them proper advice if they are in my field. So like that, there are hundreds of people who are ready to give advice free of cost. After doing all these things, don't expect the result within 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, or 5 months, or even 1 year or 2 years. Have patience. Respect yourself and respect others. You think that, okay, I am putting in my effort in the area which I like. Okay, then the result will come. It will definitely come. Have patience. Keep trying. First 3 years of your career, mold it properly and shape your career properly.
So, ma'am, thank you for taking your time and being a part of this video and providing these insights on how to grow or how to develop your career in an engineering field, especially for mechanical engineering students. So thank you again.
You're welcome, Nikhil. I really want our youngsters to join engineering and become very good engineers. And engineers, you know, even I think maybe because I'm an engineer, engineers are the brain of our human race. So we have to develop it further. We have to be proud of what we are. Use it. And I wish all the young engineers to get good career and make your dream happen. Thank you so much, Nikhil.